Now, when we hear stories like that of cars breaking through the ice or people falling through the ice, we want to know what we can do if we ever find ourselves in that situation. Hopefully we don't, but here's some helpful reminders. We'll begin with what happens if your car falls through the ice. First, when you're driving on ice, you should leave your windows partly down. Now, that's because the windows are your best chance to escape. If they're closed and your car goes through, use an emergency tool to break your windows. You're going to have one of those in your car as well. When the car is completely filled with water, the doors might be easier to open, but at that point, it's much harder to escape. Now, if you personally fall through, not you're in your car, but you fall through the ice, here are some helpful tips to remember as well. Don't take off your winter clothes. They can actually help provide warmth and flotation. You should carry ice picks or have a screwdriver with you when you're walking on the ice in case you fall through. You can dig them into the unbroken surface, kick your feet really hard to try to pull yourself up onto the ice. You may have to let the water drain a little bit, but once you're out, lie flat on the ice and then roll away carefully from the hole. Hopefully you never have to be in any of these situations, but yeah. I mean, and you're cold. You might not be thinking of what should I do, but try to remember.
This is timely. I'm going ice fishing today, so I'll get some screwdrivers and I'll be ready.
Make sure you're prepared.
Yeah. Yeah. Hopefully the ice, though, at this point of the winter season is thick enough for both cars, ATVs, and people.
Yeah, great tips.
Because that's your first bet, right? Check on that first.